This is Dr. Anina Abraham, and I'm going to be explaining what retinal detachment is. Let us first look at a normal retina. In this picture, we see a well-attached retina, which is orangish, and red blood vessels going across it. The yellow round structure is the optic nerve, which takes vision signals to the brain. A normal retina and optic nerve are required for vision. The retina commonly detaches because of a tear, a hole, or a lattice in the retina. And why does this happen? In most cases, this can happen spontaneously. However, some cases of retinal detachment happen after injury to the eye. When the retina tears, liquid vitreous gets into the break and goes behind the retina, causing it to detach from its underlying layer, the choroid. What are the symptoms of retinal detachment? Flashes of light, floaters, blurred vision, a curtain dropping sensation, and finally blindness. All these are experienced at different stages of retinal detachment. How is it treated? Vitrectomy surgery is done for cases of retinal detachment. Very fine instruments are introduced into the eye, a light to see what is inside, and a cutter to remove the vitreous. Once the vitreous is fully removed, it is replaced with oil or gas. Fluid which has gone under the retina is aspirated and the retina is flattened. It is important to maintain a certain position of the head after surgery. Some patients require to sleep head down, others require to sleep on one side, and yet others are required to sleep with head up. It depends on the position of the retinal break. Your surgeon will tell you which position you need to maintain. This needs to be done for about 2 weeks. What is the success rate of retinal detachment surgery? More than 90% in fresh cases of retinal detachment. This is because of the latest advances in fine gauge vitrectomy. High failure rates are seen in long-standing retinal detachments.